sorrow is as well above them. It's about life. And hark what it is. Who brought me here to this world so long ago? Who shaped my young face and welded my bones? Who watered my hair and twisted my nose? So whoever brought me here will have to take me home. Yeah, 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 yeah. I heard a voice in my head the other day. I don't have much to say. Better get direction or you might have a fall. I need a light to see where I'm going. So whoever brought me here will have to take me songs and they're all gone. It's like crazy. And I remember
And like my first girlfriend and like all those sort of things, they're the type of memories that's coming back for me now. And I called, it's actually a girl called Alex Howard, and I was in New York about 6 months ago, and I was playing some songs, and it was just, it reminded me exactly of Alex Howard, and I thought, I've got to call her like, right now. So I picked up the phone and I said, Alex, and she went, what, who's that? I said, it's Frances Dunring. She went, oh, hello, what's wrong? I just want to let you know that, like, you're the greatest thing that ever lived, and like, you know, but I know you've got a big fat ass and all that now, but like, it's nice. She said, you haven't changed, have you? And this next song is a song that I wrote ages ago, and never, a lot of the songs you're going to hear tonight, I've had them written for a while, but I haven't put them on any CDs because it didn't really feel appropriate, but I'm going to rehash them this year, and I put them on a CD for maybe June or July. And this is a song about, well, you know, it's almost like when I put those old songs on, it's like a time machine. It's like going back in time. All them songs like Seasons of the Sun, and all them things, and like Chucky's and Love and them. What's that there? It just sends me back in time. And so this is a song called Autumn the Rain Man, which is you guys are like a concert, say them bad words. I won't say any more, alright? I'll have a swear box. Did I say this last week?
It's okay, we could understand.
I said the A word, didn't I? I'm not a very good priest, am I?
Well, I remember a time back in 83. We were down in the fields, just you and me. We watched the rain fall down together. Every day. And I know we were young and we couldn't really feel, but we didn't really care, cause the closet was real. We watched the rain fall down together every day. I wanna go back in time, cause I'm a celebration in the making. Tired out eyes, I wanna go back in time, cause I'm a celebration in the making. Autumn the river, will you take this life I have today and simplify my love away? Thank you.
And he always wanted something done in his name. And so he called me up and threatened me with a couple of his brothers. And he said if I didn't put this thing on for him, there'd be a horse's head in my bed when I got home. Larry's a Libra, but he's actually he's a you know one of the things. All you guys know about astrology or no?
Yeah.
Because Libras basically, I mean, the basic thing with Libras is they're so infuriating because they can't make their mind about anything at all. We've been planning this for 6 years. It took us 6 years to choose the venue. That's only because one of his family was an Aries that we ended up doing anyway. And so one of the things I've learned about Libras is that no matter what you say, it doesn't matter what you say, they'll just say the complete opposite. It doesn't matter. The sky's blue today, Larry. Well, actually, it was yellow yesterday. This is nice coffee. Yeah, but I've had better elsewhere. This coffee's awful. Oh, really? I think it's quite good. And there's a great story because my niece in England is a Libran, right? And her boyfriend's a Libran. And they have the strangest arguments. The arguments go like this. Where should we go tonight? You choose. No, you choose. No, I'm not choosing. I chose last time. Well, you choose. That's a Libran argument. But it's great to be here, Larry, with you. And I know you know, I was in England when Larry was a bit ill for a little while, and you know, thank God he isn't ill anymore, and he's on a happy road to recovery, which is fantastic. Which we're all talking about. I can't tell you. I know a lot of your friends were around you at the time, you know, when you were ill. But I got to tell you, being in England and on the receiving end of Denise Gordon's emails is even worse. Because she's a Gemini and they change like every 3 minutes. I love on the internet he goes send and receive, so I hit it and it comes up. Progress on Larry. Larry's really not doing very well today. He's you know, in a real bad way. And Dan and I'm sitting there going, oh God. And then the next one, within about 4 minutes, Larry's up and running around. And then I get one from Kate, who's a Scorpio, and like this one. Larry's intravenous Neptunian of the electors. You know what I mean, Larry? You know what I do? This is an old song that, well, again, it isn't an old song for you guys, but it's an old song for me. And it was a time when, especially being in the music business, it's you know, you're not really encouraged to be yourself. I don't know, you're encouraged to kind of pretend you're this, like, thing that you just can't be. And, you know, having a few planets in Scorpio, I can't take any, or I can't really bullshit myself, you know what I mean? It's very difficult. I've had a I've tried many times, and but it always ends up all right. No matter where I am in the world, I always get a package, and it's always like the brand new astrology book that's out. And so I don't have to buy astrology books anymore. And I used to keep this green in expensive sweaters, but now Larry just sends them down on me. So he's a very, very, very giving man, and I think, you know, anybody who would like any astrology readings or anything like that, you should go and see Larry because he's a lot nicer than I am. People come out of my readings crying. They come out of Larry's readings like 40 to 1. They come out of mine going, are you sure that everybody said that? Alcoholics, you know, my sponsor in the AA program, when I used to go to alcoholic meetings all the time, it's fantastic. It's like free psychology to demons. There's a bunch of psychopaths running it, and it's just, you know, And they said, I said, if I'm going to stop drinking, right, where do I go? They said, if you stop drinking, you better go to these things called AA meetings. Because I said, well, isn't that for like all these weird guys who are like losers and all that? And I went in there, like Anthony Hopkins, Eric Clapton. The whole of Aerosmith, they go like, yo! And so it's kind of like, if you're not hip, you know what I mean? If you're not in AA, you're not hip, that's how it kind of is now. So that's why I left. No, but that was about 11 years ago or something, and I had this, they said, you've got to get a sponsor. So I got this guy called, he was Mickey Bush, he was like an ex-bank robber. And he was just like, he had like scars all his face, he was a genius. And he tells this great story about, because alcoholics, they always want, if you get like 11 years sober or something, you always want like some praise for it, as if like you're doing the world a favor, you know what I mean? And he said, yeah, I went home, he lives in London, he said, I walked into my old mum and I said, Mum, I've got 11 years sober. She said, so's the cat. Isn't that good? It just brought him right back down to earth. He used to tell me the most wonderful stories about when he was drinking. He used to get drunk and wake up in all sorts of weird places and with all sorts of like strange ladies and stuff like that. And he said, look, one morning, kind of like, I think he was all hungover and stuff. He's like, taste in his mouth was awful. He's like, oh. And he looked to his left hand side, there's this woman there, and he went, ah! And he said, she wasn't particularly cute at all. He said, and he went, get out! She said, it's my house! Alcoholics are hysterically funny. If somebody asks me how long I got sober, I always say more than what I got sober. How long I got sober? 12 years. It's actually 11 and a half. If you say 12 anyway, you can say 11. How long have you stopped smoking for? 5 years now. 4 years and 2 days. I'm not singing another song on New York, but this song is, I wrote this in an apartment when, on 56th Street in New York, I just left my wife, and it was really heavy. I just lost another house, so, I used to wonder what Robert Plant was talking about, because I would hang out with Robert Plant for like 2 or 3 years, and if he saw a really cute girl, he'd say, I can fill another house, come on. I've just lost my second one, so that's, I'm doing well. And I remember I got off the plane and I had like 200 books in my pocket. I'd do the whole thing, And beautiful house in Kensington. It makes me want to commit suicide. And I got off the plane and I went into this. I got an apartment in 56th Street, a really nice building. And it actually had a floor exactly like this. My God. And I had a piece of sponge, a dog blanket that I got from the dog, and like a really crap telephone that somebody had thrown out, a DAC player and my acoustic guitar, and I had that, I exactly like that for about 4 months, and that's why I wrote that album, Tall Blonde Helicopter. And a lot of the songs are on, this is one of the songs that should have been on Tall Blonde Helicopter, but didn't actually make it. And it's going to be on my new album that comes out in the summertime. This is called Living in New York City. Mother says I gotta slow down, get a handle on my life. I was living in California with a Jewish princess for my wife. From a Catholic schoolyard, singing to the home. I'm good in New York City, and it feels like home. Ooh, mama says I better think again, 'cause play. I'm here in Acapulco, and my girlfriend's name is my wife's name. From a rusty bike to a mobile phone. Catholic, nobody touches you when you're Catholic in Catholic families. You know what I mean? Catholic families don't, they literally don't touch each other. Jewish families are very different because my only wife actually was Jewish, and when I walked in, I was terrified because I had this woman running towards me like a mother with these big square glasses on, going, "We love you!" I said, "What do you want to eat?" "When are you going to convert?" So Catholics, you know, that's a whole other thing, Catholics. Catholics are just like, I don't know why they bother having families because they don't talk to each other anyway. Actually, Italians are like Catholic Jews, aren't they? I love them, you know, the old Jewish grandmother, the old grandmother was a genius because she had, they'd all come around, all these like old Jewish women, you know, 8 years old, and they all had the same voice. They said like, "Ah, my back." And then what did she say? She said, "I shrink in my shoe." But they were very kind people, very nice, and actually they gave me my first, I have a lot to thank them guys for, because it was the first time I received any affection at all since I was born. Catholics are telling the same thing, you get beaten with a rubber stick. It's like that Monty Python sketch when he goes, you know, "I was whipping a shoebox in the middle of the road." Luxury. I had to get up in the morning, clean the lake. My mother would whip beat us until we bled to death. But this is the only time, this is my attempt at a love song I wrote a long time ago. I wasn't really in love, but I just thought it might be a challenge to like fly a bit. Good morning, how are you? I've been out of my head with all the things that you said, because I'm in love with you. I feel so alive, because I got you by my side, and now I don't have to try to get my feelings true. I used to be so afraid to sing you a love song. there any requests by any numbers you want to put on number 3, number 2, number 3? Homegrown? Any homegrown?
Yeah.
Well, the homegrown is actually about that that family we had. I remember, you know, the we love you, like that. They say that the guy who says money is the root of all evil didn't have any. You know what I mean? And I kind of believe that. I like money. I'm big into cash. I love cash. Everybody talks about this spiritual stuff and all that, just cash. You know? You guys have not been near, I'll go buy a Mercedes, don't you? But the one thing I do know about cash, I mean, you know, I'd love to, you know, if any of them spiritual people want to give me their cash, I'm totally up for it. I will receive, brother. They call me the receiver. But the one thing I didn't know about it, they say if you do things just for money and you don't make any, you've lost everything. And it's true, isn't it?
Yeah.
So it's always good to have another reason to do things rather than just money. And, you know, because if you don't make any money, then at least you've got, you know, you might have some meaning, or you might have, you know, you might have achieved something out of it, and you don't feel, you know, like it's been a waste of time in your life. And one of the things that I've seen in my life on several occasions is money taking over people's lives, and it takes us apart. It absolutely rips families to pieces. And I saw this. I was sitting in the garden one day, and I saw this happen up in New Jersey. And this is a song I wrote ages ago about this whole thing. This is a song I'd like to dedicate to my good friend Barry. I'd like to finish the evening tonight with this song called Homegrown. Actually, I'm not going to finish the evening, but one more song after this.
I wonder around the garden, I watch the family crumble in the hallway.
that more satisfaction, baby. I'd just like to say to Larry, we're very happy that you're feeling well and you're hanging out with me. You're a wonderful friend of mine, and you've given me great things over the years, and I faced you all the way through here, and I have a great Christmas, happy new year, and it's good, you know. Very different setting to do a gig in, and I absolutely loved it. You guys were really, really, really amazing, so thank you.
So are you.
This is a song that they tell me that, is there a TV program called Scrubs or something?
Scrubs.
Scrubs. What is it called? Scrubs. 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 Well, somebody sent me an email, it was a big deal, but I didn't know what it was. They could have called it, like, the Spaceman from Ohio or something. But they said that they're playing this song and they've taken it for, they're playing it on the radio all throughout America now, in like weird pockets of America, because they've put it on a compilation album, and then apparently it was on that TV program. I mean, my bank account's blown up. That's why I bought the Ralph Lauren Under Fund.
Here's to your love.
your children, and here's to you having a good life. Good
decided and helped. She took me home to meet her mom. And I thought I was cute in my new shoes and my suit, but the old girl wouldn't give a damn. No matter how she tried, the old girl couldn't hide the disapproval in her voice. She took me in the kitchen, said she needed answers. Before that she could make a choice.
Are you Irish? Are you Catholic? Are you Jewish? Are you Klan? Are you pro-choice? Are you Baptist?
I said, I ain't anything. I'm just a man.
Happy birthday, dear friends. birthday waltz and everybody else can sing along. Okay, ready? Yeah, okay, ready?
Happy birthday, we love you. Happy birthday, and may all your dreams come true. When you are about to candles, one life stays alone. Is the love light in your eyes wherever you go?
You guys want some cake?
Yeah. Thanks, please.